By word of mouth, through song and story, slaves began to learn that there was a new place where they might find sanctuary and freedom. It was called the North. But where was the North, and how did you get there? Imagine yourself a slave on a Carolina plantation, illiterate, undernourished, without a map or even the simplest directions. Which way do you run? And how do you know friend from foe along the way?
For the old man is waiting for to carry you to freedom. Follow the drinking good.
The layers of meaning within slave song made it possible for blacks to send messages to each other in a variety of situations, and the black spirituals were essentially all about yearning and freedom.
According to legend, Follow the Drinking Gourd was written by a southern free black carpenter known only as Peg Leg Joe. The lyrics seem simple, but they contain secret instructions for a safe escape route north. The drinking gourd was the Big Dipper, and to follow the drinking gourd meant to walk at night under cover of darkness, keeping the North Star in sight.
Dead trees show you the way.
The line, "The dead trees will show you the way," referred to dead trees along the Tom Bigbee River.
Left foot, peg foot, traveling on
referred to trees that had been marked with charcoal and mud drawings of a peg leg and a foot, leading runaway slaves north into Tennessee. And with every slave who attempted to escape, over time, slaves and those who harbored them came to know this song, and a whole lexicon of secret signs and symbols, songs and hiding places that began to make up the disparate lines of the Underground Railroad.
There is something referred to as the slave grapevine, which was extremely effective. Not given access to education and with an extremely limited opportunity to write out directions and thoughts, it was important to speak the news, keep the news, pass on the news. Information was valuable.
They knew the disguises, they knew the spirituals, they knew the codes, they knew the knocks, they knew who was a riverboat captain. All of these things they knew, so it was a very intricate, complex system.
If a white man should grasp his ear as a black man passed by, for example, it meant, "Follow me to a safe house." And there were secret handshakes to identify friend from foe. It's also believed that if a house had a hitching post in the shape of a slave holding a lantern, the house was an Underground Railroad station. Ironically, the same hitching post that today has become the detested lawn jockey of suburbia was once a symbol by which thousands of enslaved men and women found their way to freedom.
The fact is, the South understood, slaveholders understood, that their slaves were resourceful, and that if information could be transferred back and forth, it would be transferred back and forth. There were many ways in which slaves could communicate with non-slaves, with people outside the plantation, and sometimes with people outside the South altogether.
And those people in the North had a name. They were called abolitionists, which to many was just another name for troublemaker. Hear that?